Hillary Clinton has just dug a hole for herself that now requires an indictment. Jim Comey swore that Hillary Clinton sent classified emails. Accordingly, she lied to us. He knew that she sent classified emails. So if the FBI knew that she sent classified emails, did they ask her whether she did? If they did, irrespective of her answer, they would have had to take her out in cuffs. If she said no, that would have been lying to the FBI. And if she said yes, that's admitting that she violated federal criminal statutes. If the FBI already knew she had sent classified information on her private server, and they did not ask her if she did, that means that they intentionally did not want to charge Hillary Clinton. Now, folks, Jim Comey was the man in charge who made the decision to prosecute Martha Stewart for lying to the FBI on a case that had nothing to do with national security. Hillary Clinton's case had everything to do with national security and, worse, everything to do with the future of this nation. And when Hillary Clinton says, what I told the FBI, which he, Comey, said was truthful, is consistent with what I have said publicly, she is telling us that she repeated the lie that she told us about not sending classified emails when she spoke to the FBI. That means that she lied to the FBI. She is clearly stating that what she told the FBI is what she told us. She lied to us, as per Comey, and now she's telling us she told the FBI the same lie. Jim Comey's hands are now tied. He cannot do the dance anymore about how there was no intent, or that he's not sure what negligence means, or that it was only recklessness or carelessness, or that the statute isn't clear, or that no reasonable prosecutor would go forward. Comey, the prosecutor who wasn't in that room in the interview, who didn't use the opportunity to size up a prospective defendant, who didn't use the opportunity to analyze her truthfulness and her body language, the man who didn't even speak to every one of the FBI agents in that room, who quickly made a determination that she did not have the intent, which was not even an element of the crime in the first place, is now caught between a rock and a hard place. Her response this past Sunday to Chris Wallace in an interview, when he says that FBI Director Comey said none of the things Hillary told the American people were true, says it all. Take a listen.
After a long investigation, FBI Director James Comey said none of those things that you told the American public were true.
Chris, that's not what I heard Director Comey say, and I thank you for giving me the opportunity to, in my view, clarify. Director Comey said that my answers were truthful and what I've said is consistent with what I have told the American people.
But let's hear it from the director himself.
Secretary Clinton said there was nothing marked classified on her emails, either sent or received. Was that true?
That's not true.
Secretary Clinton said, I did not email any classified material to anyone on my email. There is no classified material. Was that true?
There was classified material emailed.
Secretary Clinton said she used just one device. Was that true?
She used multiple devices during the 4 years of her term as Secretary of State.
Secretary Clinton said all work-related emails were returned to the State Department. Was that true?
No, we found work-related emails, thousands, that were not returned.
Secretary Clinton said neither she nor anyone else deleted work-related emails from her personal account. Was that true?
That's a harder one to answer. There's no doubt that there are work-related emails that were removed electronically from the email system.
Secretary Clinton said her lawyers read every one of the emails and were overly inclusive. Did her lawyers read the email content individually?
No.
Jim Comey, for all his truth saying, has an obligation to his oath and the Constitution. He has an obligation to recognize what this woman has said not once, not twice, but at least 10 times. And what he has said under oath